إن الحمد لله. Verily all praise is due to Allah. نحمده, we praise Him. ونستعينه, we seek His assistance. ونستغفره, and we beg Him to forgive us. ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا. We seek refuge with Allah from the evils of our own selves. ومن سيئات أعمالنا, and from the consequences of our bad deeds. من يهده الله فلا مضل له. Whomever Allah guides cannot be led astray. وَمَنْ يُضْلِلْ فَلَا هَادِيَ لَهُ. And whomever Allah leads astray from His wisdom cannot be guided by anyone. وَأَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ وَحْدَهُ لَا شَرِيكَ لَهُ. I testify openly that no one deserves any type of worship other than Allah, who's alone in that right, sharing it with none. وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. And I testify openly that Muhammad was His servant and messenger. Dear believers in Allah, at this time it is not appropriate to be fidgeting with anything. It is not appropriate to be fidgeting with prayer beads or a cell phone or with your fingers. Because our messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من مس الحصى فقد لغى ومن لغى فلا جمعة له. Whoever plays with the pebbles during Jumu'ah, then he has committed a frivolity, an act of frivolity during this hour. And whoever does that, there is no Jumu'ah for him. So do not allow your fingertips to be busy, that which indicates the heart not being attentive to these words, the speech of Allah Ta'ala, which is very important for us on this day. Allah Ta'ala has said, ظهر الفساد في البر والبحر بما كسبت أيدي الناس. Corruption has spread at sea and on land because of what the hands of the people have earned. لِيُذِيقَهُمْ بَعْضَ الَّذِي عَمِلُوا لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ. In order to make them taste part of what they have done, in order for them to return. We beg Allah Ta'ala to guide us to a genuine and sincere return to Him with devout obedience and worship of Him alone, and honoring and exemplifying the sunnah of His final messenger, salawatullahi wa salamuhu alayhi. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala has said, وَإِذَا جَاءَهُمْ أَمْرٌ مِنَ الْأَمْنِ أَوِ الْخَوْفِ. When any affair comes to them of public safety or concern and fear, أَذَاعُوا بِهِ, then they spread it. Meaning the blameworthy opponents of the guidance of Allah Ta'ala. وَلَوْ رَدُّوهُ إِلَى الرَّسُولِ وَإِلَى أُولِي الْأَمْرِ مِنْهُمْ. And had they not only returned it back to the messenger and back to those that are in authority amongst them, لَعَلِمَهُ الَّذِينَ يَسْتَنْبِطُونَهُ مِنْهُمْ. Then those among them that know how to extract the rulings would have done so. Meaning the ignorant would not have the word of the day, and they would not have the opportunity to mislead the people. But the people of knowledge and the people of leadership lead the way with insight, with the book of Allah and the guidance of the sunnah of the messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's from Surah An-Nisa, the 83rd verse. At this time, dear brothers in Islam, we turn to the leaders of the Muslims, the scholars of the Ummah, and how they address us and advise us for these trying times wherein corruption has spread in the form of viruses that are spreading among the people, coronavirus and other than that, from that which may harm the people and that which can spread and that which we are required to recognize the harm of and deal with it according to Islamic guidelines. So on this day, in the second khutbah, in our very brief address, we will listen to the words of the scholars of this ummah from Al-Lajnatu Da'imah, from the Permanent Council of Senior Scholars of the Ummah, and we'll hear what they have to say with three basic points and some final advice, insha'Allah ta'ala. Firstly, dear brothers, our scholars advise, as they have stated after convening recently and studying the issue of coronavirus and its spread around the world, they have said, firstly, it is impermissible, haram, not allowed, for any person who has been infected with this virus to attend the Friday service or congregational prayers, based upon the statement of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, لا يريد المُمرض على المسيح The one who has camels that are ill, he may not bring his sick camels to the same water source as those who have healthy camels. So if that is the case with camels and the shepherds of camels, then what about the human beings who are more honorable with Allah tabarak wa ta'ala? Also based upon the statement of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إِذَا سَمِعْتُمْ بِالطَّاعُونِ بِأَرْضٍ, if you hear about the plague or an epidemic in a certain land, فَلَا تَدْخُلُوهَا, then do not enter that land. وَإِذَا وَقَعَ بِأَرْضٍ وَأَنْتُمْ فِيهَا, and if it happens in a land and you are in that land, فَلَا تَخْرُجُوا مِنْهَا, then do not seek to flee out of that land. So firstly, dear brothers, understand that the issue is serious and that the issue needs to be addressed with texts of the book and the sunnah, and we need to interact with the society that we live in a way that secures our health and the health of our family and the health of our neighbors. Secondly, whoever has been ordered to be quarantined by the authorities, then he is required to remain in quarantine, whether it's in the house or in the hospital, and desist from attending congregational prayers and the Friday prayers. He should instead establish the prayers in his home or in his place of quarantine, based upon the statement of Shurayd ibn Suwayd al-Thaqafi, who said, كَانَ فِي وَفْدِ ثَقِيفٍ رَجُلٌ مَجْدُومٌ, there was in the delegation of Thaqif a man who had leprosy. فَأَرْسَلَ إِلَيْهِ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ اِرْجِعْ فَقَدْ بَايَعْتُكَ. And so the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam sent a messenger to convey this message to him. Go back. Meaning don't come forward to shake hands and take this bay'ah, this pledge of allegiance personally, but go back. We have accepted your pledge of allegiance. Meaning without the personal interaction. That narration was collected by an Imam Muslim. Thirdly, dear brothers, our scholars advise us that whoever fears harm or harming others is permitted to avoid the Friday prayer and congregational prayers, based on the statement of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, la darara wa la dirar, there is no harming and there is no reciprocation of harm. That's collected by Imam Ibn Majah in his Sunan and authenticated by the scholars of Hadith. So therefore, anyone who misses the Friday prayer would instead pray four raka'at of dhuhr. If anybody misses Jumu'ah, then they pray four raka'ats of dhuhr. May Allah Ta'ala bless you. In conclusion, the Council of Major Scholars advises with adherence to these instructions, the instructions, the advices, the regulations issued by the proper authorities. And it advises with the fear of Allah and reliance upon Him, beseeching Him alone to remove this calamity. Allah Ta'ala has said, وَإِنْ يَمْسَسْكَ اللَّهُ بِذُرٍ فَلَا كَاشِفَ لَهُ إِلَّهُ. If Allah Ta'ala allows some adversity to befall you, then there is no one to remove it except Him. وَإِنْ يُرِدْكَ بِخَيْرٍ فَلَا رَادَ لِفَضْلِهِ. And if He wanted some good to befall you, then there is no one to repel His bounties. يُصِيبُ بِهِ مَنْ يَشَاءُ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ. He allows that to befall or to come upon whomsoever He chooses of His worshippers. وَهُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. And He is the all-forgiving, the ever-merciful. And He says, Allah Ta'ala has said, وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمْ ادْعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ. Your Lord has said, call upon Me and I shall respond to you. So we say at this hour, اللَّهُمَّ أَنْتَ رَبُّنَا. O Allah, You are our Lord. وَنَحْنُ عِبَادُكَ. And we are Your worshippers. وَنَحْنُ عَلَىٰ عَهْدِكَ وَوَعْدِكَ مَسْتَطَعْنَا. And we are upon Your covenant and Your promise of reward as much as we are able. نَعُوذُ بِكَ مِنْ شَرِّ مَا صَنَعْنَا. And we seek refuge with You from the evil of what we have done. وَنَبُؤُ لَكَ بِنِعَمِكَ عَلَيْنَا. And we confess to You and acknowledge to You all of the blessings that You have poured upon us. وَنَبُؤُ لَكَ بِذُنُوبِنَا. And we confess to You our sins. فَغْفِرْ لَنَا جَمِيعًا. So forgive us all. فَإِنَّهُ لَا يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ إِلَّا أَنْتَ. For there is none to forgive the sins other than You. وَصَلِّ اللَّهُمَّ وَسَلِّمْ وَبَارِكْ عَلَىٰ نَبِيِّنَا مُحَمَّدٍ وَعَلَىٰ آلِهِ وَصَحْبِهِ.